Yeah, so that basically from our Gen 1 to this is a big upgrade from output and capacity. So the inverter, this is the inverter right here, batteries. So this is 20 kilowatt hours in batteries, 5 kilowatt hours per battery. The inverter is now 11.5 kW, which was 7.6 before. So essentially, you know, everything is going to whole home backup. Everybody wants to have whole home backup consistently, just making it more easy for tying in to that scenario. This actually is what our COM Lite is now. So before on Gen 1, we had a COM Lite box. It was an additional box that didn't do backup, but it was for energy arbitrage. Now we don't have that. That's actually built into the inverter. So you just need the stack. It's a one less piece, a little bit less labor. Also, we moved the DC disconnects to the outside, which I really like because that was always a pain. I hated it.
Trying to have
somebody explain that to somebody was that's not technical. That was a pain. Yes, very much. So another big thing that we added is the expansion kit. So this will be a base that allows you to add more capacity. So before, this is one inverter. Yeah, exactly. So yeah. So, and it'll actually change a little bit. That'll be all covered. This is more just to show you guys like how it's tied in really. So this will actually be look a little bit better on the base, but this is actually just one inverter and 8 batteries. So it's a big upgrade in capacity for output. That's a big help right there. Obviously we could still do 3 inverters to a gateway. So you can get up 120 kilowatt hours in battery storage and then up to, 34 kW in output.
Wasn't the Gen 1 version limited to like 5 batteries in a stack per
inverter? It was six inverter, and then you could parallel inverters, but obviously there's issues with that. So this really, you can expand quite a bit on this.
Very nice.
So yeah, it's a lot of big upgrades. They really listened to, you know, what people said that what they would like. So it's been a big help for us, at least on the support side. I work support, so
okay.
I appreciate it.
Yeah,
definitely. If you want
to have to be the one to make it work.
Yeah, I know. It's yeah, exactly. So it's a big help. They added a lot of features. We added a black start button. You can kind of see it's right here. It's a little green button. Essentially, we'll use like the reserve of the battery. There's a breaker that ties to. And if there's a reserve, so we obviously have a hidden reserve like usual. But if they have at least 1%, they can hit that button and it'll close the breaker and then utilize the reserve to kick on the system again.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, that's a big help. So. Also, too, the gateways changed quite a bit.
Yeah, it does look like you guys changed the color scheme a little bit.
Yeah, everything. Yeah, so that right now I can open this actually. Right, we went from, so before we didn't have service entrance rated, now we're service entrance rated. So you can add a breaker, it's optional, you don't always have to do that. It's an additional 200 amp breaker. We moved from the DIN rail. We used to have a DIN rail. I don't know if you knew that. So on the previous one, we had a DIN rail, which, you know, that those breakers are even just harder to supply for people. People can get those easily accessed. Exactly. So if they don't purchase it or weren't paying attention or it gets missed, you know, it costs a lot of lead time and money just to go and purchase a breaker to finish an install, which is nuts. So now we have our bus right here. You can get regular QB or QR breakers, like a Square D, any of like anything you can get at Home Depot, essentially. We have our non-backup load port, so you can tie in up to 125 amp non-backup panel. So that, and again, that's more so you can everything be whole home. You have a lot of option to load shed. Mm-hmm. We also have the ability for smart breakers. So which and on the other side, actually, I can show y'all. They have one running, just to show it's like powering a little fan. It's all controlled through the app. It's really sweet. So it's really good for load management. Like even remotely, if they'll get a notification. Oh, you're overloading. Reduce load, they can kill load remotely, still have power and they get back. If they don't, now you have a data point for, hey, y'all didn't turn off your power in time.
Right.
And they have the black start button to recover it. And that's less complaints and back and forth with homeowners, which again, helps me quite a bit. So any other questions?
Very cool. Is this available now?
I believe November, they said. Correct, Celine, when was this available in November?
In which state?
Yeah, I guess it depends on which state.
Depends on the region.
Yeah.
First launch in Texas and Florida.
Oh, well, there you go, Texas.
Yeah, it's for the UL listings, I believe. It's harder, you know, in California, so they have more requirements.
Nice.
So we're able to get in Texas stuff quicker.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Our lift shows up in 4 minutes.
Just oh, man, we nailed it.
I don't know why.